boom. The thing goes grrrr.
Oh my god, I have so much, so many mixed emotions because I just filmed another video, the one that I'm gonna post before this, just talking about my comeback, what happened to me, and it just drains me. You know, but I love you so much. If you're a newbie to my channel, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. If you have any questions, please leave them below. I watch every single comment, and I promise I'm gonna reply. And this video is actually that, a Q&A video of me just replying to all the comments, all the beautiful comments that you guys have left. I know this is a new project, having a vending machine with lashes, that's just something weird. And it's just not the norm. So of course you're gonna have questions. And who's the best to give you those answers to the best of my abilities? Me. So let's just get started. Again, on my other video, I did tell you guys that I was gonna launch a new collection. I had to close my store last year, back in December. We launched a little bit for February. We did a pre-sale. Bro, Valentine collection was just it. We sold over 5K in less than a week. And then I closed down again. I didn't keep up with the business. Bad decisions. You know what I mean? Darilis Luxury out on the go, bro. Don't ask me. I don't know what happened. Just refer to the other video. Did I speak? Pero me hija, dime que lo que. Anyways, if this turn on, yo, I don't know why, but I look so fucking cute. Like, can you see the lashes? These lashes, part of the collection, is in birthday style. And also, all vending machine lashes are gonna be $7 for the whole month because we're gonna be a year since we opened the first location. Ah, you know what I mean? So anyways, my password. I'm just gonna be reading from here. So, she'll make sure each other on point, you can tell. Thank you. So, you know, I see a lot of comments of just people thanking me. And the other video, I was like, yo, what is wrong with me? Like, a lot of people are thanking me. A lot of people are looking at me as motivation. And I'm here, like, judging myself. So, anyways, thank you so much for all the comments. Now, the first question, where can we get a vending machine like that? So first of all, in my previous video, I think it was episode 1 or episode 2, go watch those videos if you haven't watched that one yet. I mentioned that the vending machine, I got it off locally. I just Googled vending machine supplier. I got in contact with a guy. The guy did not offer a wholesale or offer the vending machine like that. He just ran to the vendings and the snack. He also refilled them with snacks. But he gave me a phone number of a guy that was selling vendings. So I bought it locally. I do recommend buying the vending locally because that way you're able to see what you're buying. That way you're able to have somebody there to support you with the vending. If you're like me, up to this day, I still don't know anything about it. But my vendor, he helps me a lot. Like, he's just one phone call away or 20 minutes from me to go ask him any questions. My vending's here in town. If I need him, he told me that he can just go and fix whatever I need. But fortunately, I still hadn't need him. The vendings, I have a year with them and they hadn't broke or anything like that. I hadn't have any problems for now, you know? And it's a plus because I have one location that I have absolutely not even family to help me, and that's Orlando. I do have somebody that has the key to the vending in case I need something, but thank God I just needed her once, and that was just to restock the vending. Also, that question, somebody has asked me that question before. How do I deal with different locations if I don't live in them? Easy, girl. Just contact somebody or talk to someone if you know somebody in that town. If you don't, just use social media. If you don't trust the person, I recommend doing a contract. Just do a contract with that person, just saying the job description and what you expect, the pay, just to go through the vending, pull the prices. It can be any person, because to be honest, the vendings that I've gotten, they're pretty good and they don't need any maintenance. But in case of maintenance, just contact a vending, you know, somebody that repairs vendings, or even a mechanic or an electrician, I hope I said that right, can even help you repair the vending. So it doesn't even have to be somebody specific that deals with vending. Now, if someone doesn't have sufficient funds on their card, but some cards do approve transactions, will it go through on the machine and will you get paid for the transaction or charged by the card machine company? I think this question is self-explanatory, because when you make a purchase online, right? And let's say you're the customer, you swipe the card and that payment goes through, you got the lashes, right? I don't have anything to do with it, because at the end of the day, I still get paid. If that makes sense. Your bank is then gonna charge you for that overdraft. You're gonna overdraft on that account if it doesn't have sufficient funds, but the transaction goes through, you're gonna have to pay that yourself to the bank with fees. Unless you have overdraft protection, you're still gonna get paid. You're still gonna have to pay $12. But that does not have to do anything with me. If the payment went through, I got the money. How you get the decorations on your vending machine? This question predominates. First of all, again, it is a regular vending machine. It's not an outer space lash vending machine. This is a regular snack vending machine that you know those people that decorate cars, decorate windows for business. It's like, I don't even know how to call it. It's like those, just Google it, like how to business things. I just got somebody, actually the person that sold me the vending put me in contact with the person that will decorate the vending. So get yourself a supplier of vending machines locally and ask them how they put the Coca-Cola logo or the Pepsi logo. Those same people that put all those logos, they're gonna do whatever you want. You know those people that also wrap cars for businesses, ambulance, cake, all of that? You contact those people. People that wrap, do wrapping design services. You Google them. City Smart, just ask her, okay? I would love to rent a machine from you. Oh my God, again, I'm starting from scratch. I don't even know how I'm gonna do that anymore. Where can I purchase a customized vending machine for my own business? Again, I did not buy it customized. I bought the vending machine and I got another person that customized the machine. Okay? And if you just wanna start, yo, listen. If you wanna start a business, do not pretend to be perfect, okay? Start that vending machine with nothing. Just like put your logo on top, Darilis Luxury, just put with them in lashes. Just start the business. At the end of the day, you're gonna start innovating as you go. If that makes sense. Just start it. Whatever, who cares about design anymore? What size tip bags do you use? I use 5x7, but you can actually use it a little bit bigger, because width-wise, it can be bigger. Also, it can be customized depending on what machine you use and the size of each space. You can customize it, so it can actually be bigger. It can actually be wider. But I just want a 5x7 for now. How much commission do you pay them all? Again, if you pay rent, you shouldn't be paying commission. It's either or. Unless you're selling over $2,000, depending on which mall, they have that difference. Some malls have over $2,000, some other malls have over $1,000. If you get paid or you sell over $1,000 on merchandise, then there's like a 10% fee that you have to pay after that $1,000. For instance, if you sell $1,000 on lashes, if you sell $1,100 on lashes and the mall is charging you 10% after $1,000, then you have to pay your rent, let's say $100 rent, plus that 10% of that $100 that was over that $1,000 limit. So instead of $100 rent, that month you're gonna pay $110. Okay, so that is the only commission that I paid when my vending sells over that amount that is stated on the lease. You should never do both rent plus commission. Do not do that. It's either or. And listen to this, the mall can tell you whatever they want. I'm charging you $1,000 rent, but if you are the one that have to negotiate with them. Whatever price they give you is not gonna be the end price. You can negotiate this, okay? So just because they tell you initially $600, do not accept that. At least try to you know, be like, $600, I think $500 will be more reasonable. I'm starting up this project, whatever. Usually, the price that they initially give you is not the final, trust me. All my malls, I'd be like, this, you finna see, is that. And usually, sometimes it's not what I offer, but it's in between. If it's not, if they offer me $600 and I offer them $500, they usually leave it at $450. So always aim higher, lower than what you want the rent to be. So if I want the rent to be $300 a month, I told them, okay, I know you offered me $500. Can we bring it down to at least $250 and maybe like some percentage? And they be like, the least that we can do is $350. I'm like, okay, $350 sounds about right. Does the mall charge an expensive rent price? Again, no. Some locations are as low as just a percentage. I have a location that I just pay percentage rate. So if I just sell $50 a month on that vending machine, I'm just gonna pay 37% of that. So 37 of $50, city, how much is the percentage? Because I don't know, I'm not a mathematician. But anyways, that's all you're gonna pay, the percentage. In that location, I'm actually not even worried. I do want to make sales, but I'm not like, oh my God, like, you know what I mean? Because it's just percentage. If I'm not doing good that month, it's not even a matter of nothing, because I just pay percentage depending on what I sell. So to answer that question, it can be by percentage, which is a plus. If you can get a location that is by percentage, get it ASAP. Like, don't even think about it. The other locations do not want percentage, they want rent. So it can go from as low as $300 all the way to $1,000. Some locations actually offer me $2,500. And I'm like, you know what? You're financing me. I don't do that rent so high, because remember, at the beginning, you might not even make what you invested. At the beginning, probably your vending is not gonna make as much. So you need to be ready money-wise to put money out of your pocket the months that your vending doesn't even sell. Because remember, there's slow months. So you negotiate whatever your income is, but just know that it can be as low depending on the location. Some locations I pay a little bit more, but it can be as low as 300 all the way to, I will say, max less than $1,000. Don't do anything over $1,000 for a vending machine, especially if after that you have to pay percentage. Okay, so read that contract really well before you decide to do something like that. When people ask me directly how much you pay for this location, I don't like to discuss my contracts like that, but I do information at least to help you. If you also are dealing with a contract, you want me to read it, you want me to give you an advice, if it's a good take, you can also message me. And I will tell you from my point of view. I'm not an expert on the matter, but at least I can help. What website did you use to buy your vending machine? Again, I did not buy it from any website. I buy it locally. But Craigslist offer up, Best Buy. I said Best Buy. No, eBay, all of those, even Facebook Marketplace. You can Google a vending machine. Use vending machine and it's gonna pop up. If you're trying to buy it online, again, it's better if you buy it from somebody locally. Just me saying, because yo, he can help you for free because you're supplying everything from them. How do you keep up with sales? This is an amazing question. Oh my God, I feel like a teacher. Okay, I'm making a video as soon as I'm done. I do whatever you want. No! Ah! Darilis, tú no estás bien for the video. Yo! Ya, Darilis, please. So how do you keep up with the sales? Every single morning, I get a sales report on my email. So guess what is the first thing that I used to do back when I was on my business? I will go on my email at 5 a.m. and check the daily sales. Now, after like 6 months ago, I stopped doing that. Sometimes I watch the sales, sometimes I don't. So what I do is I wait for the end of the month and I watch the sales. Now, I do not recommend that. It's good that daily you watch your sales report, see how each vending is doing. And if it's not selling daily, do something, bro. Do something, go to that vending, see if everything is working, swap your car, promote on social media, but do something. Your bed and your rock bottom is not gonna pay the rent. But you working your ass off will if you don't do that. Ooh, love from Los Angeles, thank you. Does it come with glue or do I get my own glue? Okay, so I just sold the lashes, right? But now, starting next month, in November, I'm bringing lashes, I'm bringing glue, and I'm bringing more applicators. So you're gonna have the option to buy the lashes itself, you're gonna have the options to buy lash combo, lash glue and applicator, and lash bundle, which contains the three plus something else, or the whatever, the glue and the applicator by itself. Those are gonna be the three options that I'm gonna have in all the vendings, okay? Did she say the vending machine was Crane Merchandise System brand? No, the Crane National that I spoke on that video is just the credit card processor company. What's it called? There's another card processor that if you don't wanna use Crane National, you can use the other one. I forgot. I just put it down, whatever. Again, where do you buy the machine? In Spanish, somebody asked if does this vending, you have to report it to the IRS? For you to even have the vending machine on a mall location, you need to have an LLC. You need to have your company created, of course, with the IRS. And of course, you need to report the daily sales every year with your income tax. depending on which company you create, is how you're gonna report it to the IRS. But every income that you get, you need to report it on the IRS. That's why it's not only the lashes. That's why you also have to include tax, because mall charges you tax, Crane National charges you tax, and the IRS charges you tax. So price your lashes accordingly. A new client watching this video, think about why the prices of the lashes are the way that they are before you think, oh, Amazon is cheaper, oh, this is cheaper. Like, support small business, bro. Can you? Thank you. Hey, boo, do you have a machine license to be in the mall? Yes, I do. I have an LLC. Do you need to have a business account? No. I don't have a business account, but I do have a separate business account that I deal with everything. Basically, malls are with checks. I'm paying with checks. Recently, one of the other malls have the option of paying with automatic, which is a plus. I hate this checking system, bro. I'm so late all the time. It's disrespectful. But anyways, you don't need a business account, but I do have everything separate just for a matter of filing yearly. But it is a plus that if you get it, but I'm a procrastinator at heart. I'm actively changing that. So yes, get a business account. North Carolina, New York, Manhattan, Dallas. Yo, so much love. Atlanta, Florida, Orlando, Socrates Mall. So that is it from all the questions on the last video. She said, I don't want to get scammed. Where do you buy the vending machine? Bro, can you just get it locally? Please, just get it locally. That way you don't get scammed. And if you get scammed, so what? Work again and buy another machine. Because every time that you think about getting scammed, it's like you put in negativity first. If you get scammed, you got scammed. It was meant to be. But at least you started your business. Your business. So now that was it on that. And look at this. I've been thinking of doing this. I go to the outlet and run into your machine, and now ended up seeing your video. How crazy. I guess this is my sign to get my machine too. Thanks for the info. Oh my god. This is why I make the video. This is why I started this. To inspire, start your business, okay? And it's funny because this one time I went to one of my locations in PA, and I found this girl that took a flight just to go see my vending. And she was so amazed when she saw me, because I don't know if it was karma or what, luck. We found each other when I was restuck in the machine, and I just gave her some freebies, you know, because of course the love and support, she deserved it. Okay, so let me see on my other video. I was thinking about purchasing a vending and wondering how to get started. I'm gonna make more videos, but if you guys can leave questions on the bottom, that'll be a plus, because sometimes I don't even know what you guys want to know. This one. Did you have a business plan or write a proposal to approach locations to put the vending machine? First of all, I didn't have a business plan. And each business without a plan is doomed to fail. Let me say this shit again. Every business without a business plan is doomed to fail. So please have a business plan. Do not be like me. And yes, I do have a... We can talk about that on my next video, what I sent to the mall. Because I do have a standardized email that I send to each mall. So we can just talk about that. Do you need a permit? Yes. I love watching your videos. God bless you. I was thinking for this for a while. You pushed me to open my business. I went through some other situation. My baby daddy, that's the best thing you can do for your daughter. First time viewer and your energy. Thank you, my love. Thank you. I'm proud of you. And oh my god, this one, oh my god, you're doing just wonderful. Ay, Dios mío, I missed you. When you got your vending machine, did they do payments or you need to pay for everything on front? I own every single machine that I have. I pay for everything on front. That's why I recommend getting a used vending machine. Because a brand, why would you even get a brand new vending machine when you don't know if this is a business that's gonna be good for you? Buy a used. I'm glad I found you. Thank you, Irene. I love your accent. Thank you. Do you go through a company to get your vending machine, or do you find someone selling one? I found somebody that does this for a living. Do you have someone or a company that can help you fix it or stand by? No. If my machine breaks down, I'm fucked. And also, does your machine take cash and cards? It takes both. But I have 4 locations that people only use card, and I have 1 location that people just use cash and card. That's the only one. The other ones, people are lazy to put cash. I've done a lot of research. Do you use a local vending company? To where you live, or do you have your ship? I got my ship to all the locations that I have, and shipping is about $400 to $500 depending on location, and it can be more. Can you share more information on how to make contracts with them all, and how it is the normal rate for the rent? That's gonna be another video. Do the location collect a fee? I already explained that. My business entity is an LLC. Where do you get lashes? I get it from my supplier. You can get lashes from me. I can be your wholesaler. You need an LLC to start this business. I speak French. Who can translate this video to which language? I saw your vending machine at the mall today. Oh my god. And where is your vending machine from? I guess it's from China. I think I'm made in China, because I have some things that I'm like, you know what? This has to be made in China, because if it's made in the United States, it had to be rica y sabrosa like me. But no, it was made in China. And Life of Latia, thank you so much. SJ, Sandra, her variety. Yo, follow her variety. I love her so much. Jessica, Perla, and Pierre, Chrissy, True November, The Juicy, Juliana, Bon, and whatever. Thank you so much for everybody that commented on my video. I love you so much. I hope I answer all of your questions. I think I touched all the points that I've been getting on all my DMs. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any underlying problem, question, whatever, do not hesitate. My next video, please tell me down below, so we can do it. I'm back with another video, and I'm also gonna be back on TikTok again with the video and my craziness. Thank you so much, and don't forget to go on Instagram, follow me. If you haven't subscribed yet, do not be a hater. Turn your notifications on so you can watch me on my next videos, okay? And also, so you can stay tuned, follow me on Instagram, because we're relaunching. I don't know why I keep saying relaunching. What am I launching on? Hookah or what? Relaunch, okay? It's launch, like lunch. I eat lunch. I love you so much. Spread the love, spread the vibe.